Happy Valentine's Day, Toronto. I'm Brandon Gomez, and right now we're hanging out at the St. Regis Hotel. And you know what? Today's a day definitely to celebrate love, but we also want to celebrate the singles in this city. Shout out if you're single right there, right, Jen?
Yeah.
Relationship expert Jen Kirsch is with me. How are you doing this morning?
Doing really good. I'm really excited because Valentine's Day can really suck.
Yes.
But it's also a great day to meet people, and it falls on a Friday.
Can we talk about meeting people?
Yes.
And let's dive in and let's be really real here.
Okay.
Because there's a lot of people watching right now. You live in Toronto.
Yeah.
And people will say this city can be very difficult to meet someone. A lot of people say it's a screw face capital of the world. People say everybody's looking to see what do you do rather than what your personality actually is. So is that a myth or is that actual truth?
Brandon, it is such a myth.
Yeah.
I hate when people come to me and they're like, there are no guys in Toronto, or there are no women in Toronto. There are. Your method is just not good.
So what are we doing wrong then?
No one is walking in to your living room while you're binging Netflix and hitting on you.
Right.
And like, I want you forever. You need to be out and about. And we were talking before we came on camera about a recent article I wrote. I call it...
That's the one in the Toronto Star, right?
In the Toronto Star, right. And I call it low-tech dating.
Okay.
We need to put our phones down and our apps away. And we need to be open to meeting people in real life. So right now we're at the St. Regis Toronto. We're sitting at a bar. This is a great place to saddle up, or really any bar or restaurant in the city where you'll normally be, to saddle up. And a great place to meet people. You could order a cake like this King's Cake.
That looks
which
amazing.
Which is a great conversation starter.
So can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
If you were sitting here, like let's say we didn't know each other.
Yes.
You were right there and I'm on this end of the bar.
And I see you.
Would you say what's up?
No, firstly,
I should be saying what's up.
No, I'm saying what's up.
Yeah?
But I'm already coming to sit right by you and pretending I'm not.
Okay.
And then I'm ordering my drink.
Got it.
Maybe taking a sip.
Yeah. Do a little cheers.
And then I'm like, oh, what are you drinking?
Got it.
What brings you here?
Because sometimes breaking the ice, no pun intended, is the hardest thing. Oh, that was great.
You have
how
to
you did
sip
that.
After you cheers.
Okay, right, true. Because that's
sip,
yeah.
That's a thing.
Sorry, keep me looking in my
eye. Contact. Sip, yes, give that to me. Great.
I was so worried about my question.
No, but break the ice. It sounds crazy in your head. What brings you here? What are you drinking? Are you from Toronto? Do you come here often? They sound like lines, because they are lines. You gotta break the ice.
Do you go by yourself, though, to these places, or should you bring a friend?
I think friends can be intimidating. So I thank you so... Oh, that's beautiful.
That
thank
amazing.
You so much. I like to go somewhere where I'd already be. Sometimes I sit with a book. Sometimes I may be on a deadline writing an article.
Can you do this?
Very romantic.
Hey.
And then you joke about this.
Yeah.
Definitely don't feed your date on the first date. No, that's a mouthful.
That's a mouthful. No, Jen, those are some really great advice pieces. And here's the thing. I know so many people are watching right now. They're like, they want to hear more. They want to hear more. We have more to share with you because even though, no pun intended, this is a 13-layer cake. But we want to make sure that if you are celebrating by yourself, that you celebrate properly. And if you still are want to find that love,
go out and meet people.
Yeah.
And don't be afraid to make conversation.
Okay.
Worst could happen, you get rejected, move on. There's probably someone sitting on the other side willing to feed you 13-layer chocolate cake.
I love it. All right, so much more coming here from the St. Regis Hotel with Jen Kirsch. Don't go anywhere, but in the meantime, I'm going to send it back inside to the studio.